In this video, I will show you how to make a simple frequency generator with any 555 and a few parts. This is the circuits diagram for any 555 simple frequency generator, and it consists of a few common parts. IC NE555 is here. A resistor with 33k ohms is here. A potentiometer with 20k ohms is here. A capacitor with the value of 10 UF and 25 volt is here. A 220 PF capacitor for high frequency is here. A capacitor with the value of 0.01 UF for a filter is here. A LED for the output indicator is here. A 850 ohms combined resistor is here. A mini breadboard. Terminals connectors are here. And all parts will be soldered on the mini breadboard. This is any 555 oscillator's frequency formula from its datasheet. A resistor R1, potentiometer R2, and capacitor C determine the oscillator's frequency. A capacitor of 10 UF is for low frequency range. And a capacitor of 220 PF is for high frequency range. Here we go. All parts have been installed and soldered on the mini breadboard. This side is for the input of DC power, and that side is for the output of square signal. White wire pin in this position is for low frequency range, and pull it out or pin in right position is for high frequency range. As shown in the diagram for switching the capacitors, for convenience, the breadboard are fixed on a piece of wood, and wires are connected. Red is for DC positive, black is for DC negative, and yellow is for the output square signal. The NE555 maximum output current is 200 mA. It is okay for this LED circuit as a load. However, if a larger load required, it will need to add a larger capacity of circuit, such as the circuit with a MOSFET associated like this. As an example is here, a 3-watt globe as a load, a 103 ohms resistor, and a MOSFET of 5N50. The DC power has been connected to any 555 oscillator and MOSFET circuit, but it has not switched on yet. Switch the DC power on. A multimeter indicated. Input DC 12.14 volt. A LED is flashing, and this is in the low frequency range. Adjusting the frequency. Flashing fast now. Pull the white wire out. Now it is in high frequency range. So a LED is showing steady. In the diagram, the high frequency range is connected to a 220 PF capacitor. Due to the high frequency, we cannot see the LED flashing by eyes. However, 70 kHz or so is showed by the scope. Adjusting the frequency. It is 90.9 kHz now. The frequency increased. The off time decreased for the output square wave. It is 100 kHz now. That's it. The experiences showed as examples only. Incidental speaking, formula here is the oscillator's frequency calculation, which affected by a resistor, a potentiometer, and capacitor. This resistor and potentiometer can be chosen the different values, which will result the output waveform changed. The capacitor here can be chosen a single or multi-values as the purposes. According to the formula, the capacitor's value will affect the output waveform as well, similar to the resistor and potentiometer do. Now you've known how to DIY a simple frequency generator with NE555. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, comment and subscribe if you've enjoyed the video. Your encouragement is my motivation.